This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. According to the National Center for Learning Disabilities, one in every 20 public school students has a neurological disorder that affects their ability to process information. In every one of those kids, the disorder may show up a little differently. Some of them may have trouble with reading or writing, others with math. Still others will have trouble focusing or listening. This month, the Hillside School, a private school in the Lehigh Valley, designed for kids with learning disabilities, celebrates 25 years of helping students overcome them. Laura McHugh shows us how they're changing lives and stereotypes at the same time.
Heather Tadler isn't your typical college freshman. In fact, she technically hasn't even graduated high school yet. But Heather hasn't let that or any other obstacle keep her from taking 9 credits at Lehigh Carbon Community College. Through a program at Whitehall High School, seniors can finish classes there in January and get a jump start on their college careers.
I want to be a special education early elementary school teacher because I feel as though that I would be good in the fact where normally teachers that do teach it don't know firsthand what it is.
Heather knows how it feels to live with a disability and hopes to spend the rest of her life helping others overcome them. She's already started by going back to the school where she went from struggling with dyslexia to managing it.
When I left here, the strategies that I was taught came with me.
The 6th graders at the Hillside School hang on Heather's every word. Next year, most of them will transition from Hillside into a mainstream school.
I think that this is a place where they get a running start. They get to find their islands of competence. They get to find where they need to work a little harder, and then they learn the strategies. And when they learn the strategies, then they become independent.
Every student at Hillside School has a learning disability, and many parents share similar stories of their smart kids struggling in the classroom.
Every night, it would be hours and hours of homework, and he would come home from school, he'd be frustrated. He'd be near tears.
The teacher would do all the things with the letters and the sounds, and pretty much Eli just wasn't there. I don't know where he was and what he was doing, but his mind wasn't there.
A learning disability is noticed in a student when they shouldn't have a problem. They have everything going for them that looks like that they should be a success, but yet they are not successful academically.
Administrators estimate more than 80% of the students at Hillside have a language-based learning disability like dyslexia. Kids with this disorder understand the spoken word and can listen attentively to stories, but they can't decipher words written on a page. Heather's form of dyslexia caused her to switch letters and numbers that look alike, like a lowercase b and d, or the numbers 6 and 9. To manage these disabilities, teachers emphasize reading, writing, and language therapy.
Our standards are we want them reading, we want them thinking, we want them being able to produce the written word, and so we can do it from a different angle. We aren't teaching to the test.
Susan Ayton was one of the first teachers Hillside hired when it opened in a church basement in 1983. Back then, they had 10 students in the whole school. Now they can accommodate 128 students.
Sometimes she made herself look like her father.
As Susan reads the story of Helen Keller with third grader Eli Erfer, she hears an improvement. When Eli started at Hillside in kindergarten, he barely recognized the different letters and their sounds.
Let anyone comb her hair.
Now, instead of isolating individual words, Susan says he's reading for meaning.
He's finally figured out how to read. So he's seeing success. And, you know, when a kid learns how to read, they want to read, like, everything.
They seem to succeed because I believe in them, that they will try harder for me because I'm not pushing them I'm not disappointed, I'm not discouraged, I'm not tired. I'm just supporting them. This is where I'm trying. I'll tell them flat out, this is where I want to go. This is what I want to do for you, and I'm there to be your helper. I'm not there to do it for you. You have to do it.
Susan says the students must learn how to manage their disability independently, since they'll have to do it their whole lives.
Learning disabilities are never cured. They don't go away. What happens is that you learn to compensate, you learn to work, you learn to bypass.
Using strategies like mnemonic devices and computer software programs, the kids who started out hating school find success.
When I look around and I see the other students, I know that they're successful learners, and they might all learn differently, but they're all meaning success.
He had more confidence to raise his hand and give answers in school, and he would come home and say, you know, I feel like I know more here. I feel better about saying things. I don't feel like I'm dumb or I don't know anything. I don't feel as if I'm stupid. I feel like I really know things. I feel like I'm learning.
In 25 years, more than 650 students have come and gone through Hillside. Many, like Heather, return to give advice.
You have to advocate for yourself because your parents aren't going to go to school with you.
Heather dreams to one day find herself back in the school for good, not as a student this time, but as a teacher. For Tempo, I'm Laura McHugh reporting.